MacArthur drops a atomic bomb.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. This is 1951, turn 19. And I suppose within the game, still, we can call it a somber New Year's, as I think in sort of the 6 month increments that this game happens, and it is now 1960. So the war has been going for 9 years now, slowly drawing to a close. But like I said, I want to play it out. China's playing it out, so let's get going. All right, China's paying off the 12 damage to their major factory at Peking. They're building 3 fighters and an anti-aircraft gun. I only have one. Sorry, my animals are fighting again. I have one attack that I want to do this turn, and that's taking these 2 jets and going 1, 2, and attacking these 3 Sato transports there. So, I think that was it. Yeah, that was the only attack I was really going to make. So we can quickly... So he's got 3 transports. So there'll at least be 2 rounds unless my 2 jets can hit right off the bat. All right, so let's see here. So the 2... Yeah, 2 jets. Then they scored both hits. So all 3 will die. Let's see what they roll back. And they failed. All right, so Sato has lost their 3 transports. That's going to damage kind of their... Well, not really damage their war effort too much. But it does set them back as far as getting ground troops off of, say, like the Philippines and stuff. All right, so non-combats. So jets can go 5. They went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They'll head back to Peking. Get back up there to defend the capital after the last Allied strategic bombing run really hurt them. And then going into the rest of the non-combats, I have decided as China that it is not feasible to hold out any longer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these tanks and bring them to Yunnan with the fighter. This infantry will join them. And then we are going to take the transport and grab these 2 units off of Sumatra and put them into Burma. These three artillery are going to abandon Malaya as well and move up to Burma. There's no sense in trying to hold out down there. Outside of that, I think what I wanted to do was, I was going to shift some units again. Yeah, so up here, I was going to shift 2, I was going to shift 1 unit from Shanghai down to here to reinforce the factory here. Unfortunately, I realized I probably should have taken the tanks away from India sooner because this minor factory is now exposed. Well, I think what I could do, I could take a couple tanks maybe from... No... I shouldn't do that. I shouldn't split my forces any further than any more than I need to at this point. Just trying to think here. What else can I do as far as China with any non-combat? I don't think there is much else. I mean, I don't want to abandon Manchuria just yet. Oh, the Chinese tank up in Ulaanbaatar is going to come back to Peking. The lone Soviet tank is going to fight it out for there if the Allies come knocking. Other than that, I just trying to decide. I mean, I could, well, you know what? I think at this point, actually, no. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to start abandoning the coasts. So these three are going to come here. They're going to come here. These guys are actually going to retreat back. But we'll leave one. Actually, we'll leave one infantry behind. And here to at least put up a token defense against the allies when they come. And then, yeah, I think that might be it for China. Like I said, I don't want to abandon Southern Manchuria just yet. But also, I also don't see a reason of holding it much longer. If anything, here's what I'll do. I'll take the last three tanks from Southern Manchuria and move them back to Peking to reinforce there. Thus leaving three infantry, which actually now I can just take off that army marker because in Manchuria now there's only going to be three infantry defending Southern Manchuria. Actually, before I even finish, I actually realized I missed an attack. So I was going to take one infantry off of Manchuria just to re-grab North Korea, just to add another buffer plate against the Americans. Oh, and actually, I meant to do it in Manchuria, in Northern Manchuria. I meant to just create a buffer of three infantry so that way the Americans can't just blitz their way down. Right? Is that what I wanted to do again? No, never mind. No, that is not what I wanted to do. Nope, that's right. Because I had discussions about this and I realized that the transports in Japan then could get an easy land in Southern Manchuria and cut off those forces. So I'm not going to do that. Apologize for that, guys. So I think that's pretty much it for China's turn. And they will end the turn with 39 plus one extra IPC for war bonds. So China will end their turn with 40 IPC. Well, that's going to be it for the communists this turn. Or I should stop saying communists now since China's the only country left standing. I mean, they're slowly retracting back into their territory. However, the Allies are coming in from Western China pretty hard. I mean, look at all those NATO tanks out there. Like they're just barreling right on in. So, let's deploy real quick. So basically everything is going to deploy. It's going to deploy to Peking. So this anti-aircraft gun and the, I'm super zoomed in. Sorry about that. At least try and make any more ally. When the next allied ground assault comes on Peking, can learn something from the Russians and just place a bunch of anti-aircraft guns there and hope we can hold. So like I said, China will get 40 IPC at the end of the turn, and we'll see you guys for the Allies turn 19.